Hey, good morning, Summit. This is Edward, and this is your weekly update. Jake is not here this week. He's on vacation, and so he'll be joining me again next week. So make sure you share this on all your platforms so we can get the word out and get some things going. As you know, the fall is, not the fall, but the summer's coming to an end, and that means school is starting. And so most schools start next week, which means most of us will be in a routine. And so make sure you get these announcements out and make sure that you share this on all your platforms. Now, let me share a couple of things with you. Next Wednesday night at August the 11th, our student ministry is doing a color war, and it's going to be crazy. It's just nuts. Just trust me. Make sure your student is there. If you've got a new sixth grader coming up into the ministry, or a sixth grade grandchild that's coming up into the ministry, make sure you get them there at 6 o'clock next Wednesday night for our back to school bash color war. They need to wear a white shirt. If they don't have one, we got some for them that they can wear, but it's going to tie dye their shirt. It's just this cool deal. So make sure you get there. Invite a friend. If you're listening to this and you're a student, make sure that you can get there on next Wednesday night at on August the 11th. Also, on September the 8th, our children's ministry is starting back their Wednesday night program. And so there'll be half of the group that meets one Wednesday night. The older kids will meet the next Wednesday night, and they'll rotate back and forth on that. So if you have a child in our preteen children's ministry, be looking at those emails that our children's ministry sends out every week. Kid Venture sends out an email every stinking week. Make sure you know what's going on for children's ministry. So August the 11th and then September the 8th are those two days for student ministry and children's ministry. And then at the end of this month, we're going to be relaunching our small groups. Over the last month, Jake, who is over our small groups and connections ministry, has met with all of our small group leaders and cast a vision, and really excited about that. He's done a great job, and I so appreciate his faithfulness in that. But now it's time to put the feet on the ground and get people connected in small groups. So if you're looking for a small group, you're new, you've just come to Summit in the last few months, and you've not got plugged into a small group, at the end of this month, I think it's on August the 22nd, you'll have an opportunity to connect to a small group and get to know folks and begin to grow on that. So let me say this to you. I know last week was a crazy week, and we have so many of our staff on vacation this week, kind of their last hurrah before school starts and that, and they're resting, and they deserve it. They worked like crazy last week. It was all hands on deck for Kid Venture Live. But I'll say this, we couldn't do it without you, Summit. Your faithfulness in giving and serving and doing all the things that you do, we couldn't do it without you. In fact, last Thursday night, I was speaking at Kilgore College for a real good friend of mine that's moving back to his home, and they resigned a position there, and they're moving back up north. And so I went over and shared with them, and I read this passage to him as I was reading it on last Thursday night. You guys were at Kid Venture Live, and all the things that were going on were happening. And as I sat down after reading that, not only was I grateful for Jamie and his ministry and getting to honor him, I was also very grateful for you. And so I want to read this over you, Summit, just to say thank you. Because in the book of Philemon that Paul wrote, Paul said this, I thank my God always, making mention of you in my prayers. And I do. I love you, Simon. I pray for you every week and so grateful for you. And just as Paul was talking to Philemon and saying, hey, I mention you in my prayers, I think about you every day and pray for you. He goes on to say, because I hear your love and your faith, which you have towards the Lord Jesus and towards all the saints. And that's true. You love on this community. And last week was just one way you do that. And I pray that the fellowship of your faith may become effective through the knowledge of every good thing which is in you for Christ's sake. For I have come to have much joy and comfort in your love, because the hearts of the saints have been refreshed through you, brother. And you have refreshed the hearts of this community, Summit Heights, and I'm so grateful for that. And listen to what he says. Therefore, though I have enough confidence in Christ to order you to do what is proper, yet for love's sake, I rather appeal to you, since I am such a person as Paul, the aged and now a prisoner of Christ Jesus. And so he's about to ask them to receive someone. But Paul was saying this, that your love affects this community. He's talking to those guys. I'm telling you, your love affects this community. We couldn't do what we do in this community. You are the church. As we talked about last Sunday, this is a movement. This isn't a building. This isn't a destination. So, Summit, I love you. Thank you. Know that we pray for you every week and love what you do in this community. As you gather in groups, you love on kids, you love on preteens, you love on people by giving away food. And just stay the course, Summit. I love you. Hey, I can't wait to see you Sunday, 10 a.m. We are going to be so stinking practical. It's going to blow your mind. I'm telling you, it is going to blow your mind how practical this Sunday is going to be. Okay, last week we dove deep. This week, I'm just going to get practical with you. Okay, love you. See you Sunday, 10 a.m.